A new study shows being lonely and socially isolated isn't just miserable, but can increase the risk of death, especially in elderly people. Researchers studied 6,500 men and women ages 52 and older from the UK for 7 years. They found loneliness and social isolation can increase the risk of death by 26%. Loneliness and social isolation? Well, what's the difference? According to one researcher, social isolation and loneliness are two sides of the same coin. Social isolation indicates a lack of contact with friends, relatives, and organizations, while loneliness is a subjective experience of lack of companionship and social contact. That also includes the lack of companionship, advice, and support from other people. Although there are differences between the two, both loneliness and social isolation can play a hand in earlier death. The study looked at both. But it is uncertain whether their effects are independent or whether loneliness represents the emotional pathway through which social isolation impairs health. But the Los Angeles Times points out the distinction between the two doesn't matter as much as what the findings mean, saying the study reinforces the need to increase social support for the elderly. They also note that this isn't the first study of its kind. A similar look at retired Americans in 2012 reinforced multiple studies that linked loneliness to numerous illnesses, including heart trouble and high blood pressure. One researcher says, "There's been such an increase in people living alone. In the last 15 years, the number of 55 to 64-year-olds living alone has increased by 50%, and it might be that people in those circumstances aren't looking after themselves so well." The people in the study reported they met with friends and family less than once a month. Researchers suggest the reason for the growing numbers of elderly being lonely or feeling isolated is ageism and the deaths of close ones. For Newsy, I'm Jasmine Bailey.